Let's go over to our man, Mr. Teddy Kegstad, as we do each and every Wednesday. And, you know, talk about, we just, you know, you just are in the right spot. We have you in the right spot. It's Fed Day.
That's right.
It seems like every time that you're on, we got to know what's going on with these currencies. And, folks, you can reach Teddy every trading day at forex-trading-unlocked.com. Teddy Kegstad, what's happening, brother?
Morning, guys.
Morning, Teddy.
Hey. We're sitting in the same spot, man.
It's going to be pretty quiet, I think, for most of the day today.
I know, man. We've been sitting in this spot since October 24th.
Right? Pretty much. For a lot of these markets, they've been in a wide range trade, for sure.
Yeah.
So, but today's going to be quiet until the Fed's done. You know, we have a dovish Fed with really no interest for anybody right now unless they say something, you know, to the opposite.
Yes. Yes. Now, what do you think about the aspect, you know, like, I guess 2 nights ago when, you know, the House of Commons speaker came out, I happened to be on the air then. I'm saying to myself, man, we should get some volatility tonight, you know, and the UK and the euro. But guess what? It flatlined. It's like, wow. I mean, is you know, the market knowing that it's going to be zero, well, you can say there's going to be chaos, meaning there's nothing happening. But it seems like the currency markets are just like sitting there like, okay. Talk to me, you know? Crazy.
Well, I think that, like you said, right now they are kind of just like not really absorbing anything. It seems like it's very lackluster as far as the information reaction is, except for the pound. The pound dollar right now is retreating right now. It's kind of a corrective move. And I really see that because, you know, yesterday May was pushing for the June 30th Brexit extension and what have you. So we know that there's going to be 3 more months of this, you know, deliberating on what's going on and what isn't going to happen. So the pound, I think, now has pushed that upper end of its range last week, and now it's going to settle back into this wide range trade, probably from 132 down to the 129 area for the next, like, basically 3 months, you know. So that's the dollar right now is kind of neutral because of the Fed meeting, but the pound dollar, it's getting hit this morning because of this news to put it back in that range, you know. So the dollar is getting a little strength today on that, but I think it's only a little, that's the only really news reactionary trade going on going into the Fed, except for the U.S. dollar Swiss. And that's the one thing that's seeing that under parity today. And actually, like the pound already started bouncing back a little bit, the pound dollar since the break this morning. But the Swiss hasn't. That's actually still hammering the lows. And it's about, I think, about 25 cents below parity right now. So, which is not that significant, except for the fact that we've been talking about parity being the dividing line for the dollar. So, and
oh, that's
I think
cool,
that they
yeah.
can stay below that, guys, and we have an indication of what's going to happen with the dollar over the next couple of weeks.
Now, okay, so can we go over this again? Because I got this up now, Teddy, right? And I can see that, you know, it got all the way up to this
1.01,
and that was testing the 1.01 all the way back to November. And now it's getting deeper into it. So the franc comes down, right?
Yes.
The relationship in the dollar is getting stronger or weaker? The dollar.
Right now, the dollar is getting weaker.
I got it. Okay, cool. Okay.
It's getting weaker against the Swiss.
I got it.
So
okay.
And the irony is that you also look at the euro, which on a daily basis, you would think of a move like, if you look at how the volatility today in the Swiss, their range is pretty strong. And usually they're less than the euro U.S. dollar is. Today, the euro U.S. dollar, it's positive with not much of a range, you know. And usually they kind of go in tandem when you have new lows or new highs being made in one of these markets.
Okay.
So that's where I think, like, that's what I was saying, like today, that parity thing is a big indication for what the dollar is going to do.
It is.
Okay.
That's pretty cool, man. Yeah, I like that. That's
because the euro U.S. dollar trade has been a very, like, you know, it's been a creeping bull for the past like 3-4 days. Like if you looked at it at different times during the day,
right?
You could have every reason to buy or sell it on the intraday, and I guarantee you, any intraday trader probably got chopped up over the last few sessions.
Right,
I would think.
And that's
every time you think it's going to be a bull, it starts to just edge its way down, you know, and you know it's chewing up all the weak stops.
Yeah.
It's a little spike, and then all of a sudden, boom, it's back into where it needs to go. And then the same would be, well, obviously, it's been a bullish trade like that. So it's been a buy dip market, but it's hard market to buy dips on. You just got to kind of get long and hang on.
Right. And you know what that's all about, folks, is that the trend is your friend. And that's when if you're on the right side of the trend, you think you're a genius in the trading business. So funny, Teddy, is that it's so true, though, right? That when you go on a streak, you're realizing kind of what you just said, that even a small move, you're on the right side of the trend. You know, you're losing, and all of a sudden, end of the day, you won. Losing, you won. I'm making it more simple than it is, but it really is. It's like, okay, if the trend is up.
Well, no, you are correct, 100% correct. That simplicity is the ultimate truth. The trend is your friend. Trade the action, not the reaction. The reaction is where you get chopped up. That's where all the emotion is.
Yeah, interesting, man.
Yeah.
Telling you. And, we'll see. I mean, Tommy and I were looking at that dot plot earlier, and the dot plot was like, what ended up happening, we were looking at it yesterday, and I had to go look it up last night to really understand what it is. And all those little dots, folks, are the governors that have voting power. That's where they think it's going.
Yes.
And it's way above where the consensus is right now.
Like we're saying with Kevin Hanks, right? That's
right.
December.
Yeah.
Lots changed since December 19th or wherever that last plot came from.
Right.
So that's going to change for sure.
Oh, that's how that works. I got it. Okay.
I believe
so. Every quarter.
I believe so.
Okay.
That's what I saw on that line.
Because I
was doing the same thing. Meeting day 12/19, and they have it up here. Projections for meeting data 12/19/18.
Okay, so that'll change.
I mean, that's before the markets collapsed on Christmas Eve, right?
Right.
What's the S&P up? 20% almost since that level?
Yeah.
I mean, remarkable.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
But look at that disparity of the dots, too.
I know, man.
So even, it's just, there might be a median take, right? Or but, man, they got three or four governors on either side. Yeah.
Yeah. Pretty wild, man. We'll see. I mean, they'll come out there, and it doesn't seem, we don't have inflation out here, so it's like, okay, how dovish is are they going to get? I mean, that's I think kind of where we're.
They're going to stay that way till the fall.
Okay, that makes sense. My perception is that they're done, and. I see that, our economy is still going good. I mean, but the reality is that the TAFs are hurting the Midwest beyond belief. I mean, those farmers, and there's not as many farmers as there used to be. But let me tell you something, folks. There's plenty of communities out there that are getting hurt. If you go look at any of those soybeans, wheat, corn, they're all down dramatically. So that's a problem, child.
But don't you think there might be a little shift in that, guys, over the next couple months with the China deal?
If they get it done, yeah.
They're talking right now in Chicago that if this deal goes the way it's going to go, that farm demand in the Midwest may be actually up threefold to China.
That'd be great.
And that's a whole topic that no one was even bringing to the table a year ago. I mean, this is something that is actually a possible reality right now.
Oh, that's a big number, man. That's a big number.
Yeah,
listen, folks, you can
right?
Yeah. I'm going to go be a farmer, man. You can reach Teddy every trading day, forex-trading-unlocked.com. Teddy, you have a great week, safe week. We look forward to speaking next Wednesday.
You too, guys. Thanks for everything.
Thanks Teddy.
Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are coming right back. We have the Dow down 72, NASDAQ off 5, S&P's off 6.5. Come right back.